Hello, my friends. Welcome to Training with KS. So this is our first video of 2022. Okay. Hope you guys have a wonderful celebration yesterday, and hope you guys also will have a wonderful day today, tomorrow, Saturday, Sunday, right? So have some shopping, relax a bit. You know, we just went through a very tough year last year, right? Imagine now we are calling 2021 last year already, right? So we have a blank sheet to write, you know, what we want to do, okay, what are our goals, or what are the plan that we want to do this whole year. I'm not saying we need to be like what we call it, too technical with all what we want to do, but at least we have some goals that we think that, you know, that we want to achieve, okay, possible, write it down, you know, what we want to do, plan for this year, and possible execute it, okay. So subscribe, like, share, comment, okay. So hopefully this year we can make even more from the stock market, okay. So let's check out the introduction first. Disclaimer: be advised that I'm not a professional trader or advisor. I am sharing my trading journey for entertainment purpose only. Any opinions, news, research, analysis, price, or other information contained in this video is my own opinion and does not constitute investment advice. I will not accept liability for any loss or damage, including, without limitation, to any loss of profit, money, asset, or any valuables which may arise directly or indirectly from use of information in this video. Trading foreign exchange, indexes, stock market, futures, commodities, energy, precious metal, etc. carry a high level of risk, and please trade on your own research and assessment. Please seek advice from a professional financial advisor for your trading needs. So today we are getting direct sunlight. Well, now this is the sunlight. Normally when I do recording, okay, I close all the window. I use the internal LED light. But now since today quite bright outside, and not too bright, because if it's too bright, there's a lot of this reflection. So it's not too bright, so just nice for the video. Okay, so now you're actually watching in the sunlight, right? Feels better, right? Okay, let's check out today is a big picture day. Okay, you want to check out the big picture, what is going on. Let's see coronavirus first, pandemic first. I'm not saying that we want to straight away jump into the no good, those things that, the sad thing. But still, okay, we want to see what is the progress, the latest story on COVID. So WHO chief optimistic of beating COVID in 2022. So there's some good news coming out. And Omicron wave may have peaked, say South Africa. South Africa say, right? This official relaxed restriction noting lower hospital admission from the Omicron variant. Okay. So there are some good thing coming in. So there are some good news coming into the media now about Omicron. So let's check out our KLCI. Wow, look at that. Last week. Big push up. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. This one probably correction coming. Because last few time it push up also quite similar, right? Quite similar. You look at this, right? We can see history. Quite similar. It reached here. Next time also reached here. So this time also it reached the same height over here. So there are some pressure over here already. Some pressure over here. And you see this formation, right? I'm not saying that if it happened 100%, this formation quite the same. So there are some pressure here. But can it still go higher? Possible. Because market want to push it, possible still go higher. But we don't know yet whether it correct or not. If we have some correction, you look at the history, right? After this big push, after this big candle, right? There is some correction, this sideways correction. After this big candle, there's a downtrend. So similar, possible there is a correction over here, How far we don't know, but as we said, we are trading the stock market, right? We are not trading the index, okay? So what is most important, as I said, is this one. It's this line. Most important, look at the daily, is this line, okay? This is the uptrend line. As long as it doesn't fall below the uptrend line, okay, we are still optimistic. The market is still in the healthy uptrend. And as long as it stay above this double top neckline, right, means the double top probably already, okay, this formation, right, already finished already. It correct until here, not until here. As I said right that day, I said this is a better place. Okay, I'm saying that between 1474 to 1453, there is correction will come to around this area, right? Okay, I said it might not reach here, it might reach here, but I would prefer it to reach here. I'm not saying that it will guarantee reach here. I say I prefer to reach here because here will be the confluence, right, with the downtrend, the channel bottom, right? So this one there will be even better, huh? But sometimes it doesn't happen exactly what we plan, right? Okay, so probably the head and shoulder, the double top pattern, the formation already done, huh? It didn't drop until here. It didn't drop until here because there is a support over here. Oh, support over here, right? So it got supported over here. So probably this one already done this double top pattern. Where else the target, it only reached here and 1474, it didn't reach 1453. Okay, our measurement is there. Remember the measurement, right? We make the measurement should be here, but not guaranteed it always reach there. That's why we always take profit slightly below the target, slightly above or below the target. We don't want to take exactly there because sometimes price doesn't reach there, right? Okay, it's supposed to come here, but it didn't, so never mind. Okay, but we already play over here. We already know what happened. So now the price is very strong, So as long as I said, the as long as the price is above this, as long as the price is above this, okay, above this, okay, we are still optimistic with the market, Okay, so let's look at index. Okay, look at global index. Look at aluminium. Okay, aluminium starting to fall, correct a bit, correction a bit, but not still an uptrend. You see, I draw a channel over here already. So this is still above this channel. As long as it's above this channel, right, we are still consider this an uptrend. Okay, if I come back here, retest, come back here, retest, because this one you rebound it up unless it broke below, then the trend already changed, right? So as long as it stay above here, the trend is still in uptrend, so don't be too worried about the metal first. I'm not saying metal will not drop, but so far it's still okay, according to the metal price, it's still going up. You see, right, higher high, higher high, higher high, higher low, higher low, higher low, higher low, it's still making uptrend, so don't be too worried yet. Of course, some of you already quite worried that this, because the steel price going down, right, you were worried that this one will continue to go down. So far, we track the price, okay, we track the price, tell us, okay, the chart tell us, we track the chart and we track the price, okay, the price is telling us it's still making higher high, so opportunity is still there, danger it haven't reached yet, right, we see the opportunity in the uptrend channel, right, opportunity, okay, the danger is where, when it fall below, then we see the danger. What is the sentiment? The sentiment is in the uptrend channel, so it's positive. What is the history, right? Okay, history tell us what? Okay, this is a long-term uptrend channel, right? This is a long-term uptrend channel, the history say this one is a very strong resistance. Okay, if it cannot break through, it will come down. So now it broken through already, means this one becomes strong support for it to go up, right? So you see, the price already came down, test one time, the support line push up, now it's testing again, I'm not saying that this one will not drop, but now it's still okay, right? Looks okay, Let's look at steel. Okay, steel is still hanging around here, Steel is not so strong, Slightly, slowly going down, not very strong. Look at XME a bit difficult, XME just a bit difficult to, let me see, Maybe I think XME, we draw it the wrong way, I think starts from previous. XME, I think we should draw it like this. So it's sideways price action, so there's no momentum yet. So let's take a look at the steel home. Okay, steel price start to drop, China steel price start to drop, so not so good, Look at the Shanghai industrial metal. Industrial metal still sideways, still okay, So our more important one we want to look at is this one and this one. This one and this one. Okay, for me, more important. You see this one aligned, right? These two. This one is a bit sideways market already, a bit sideways already. Maybe I think this one I change it. I think this one and this one align. Sideways. Now it's sideways. Okay, this one and this one is here aligned, right? Align. Okay, so now it's sideways. Not saying that still is dropping, but still got no momentum to go up for now lah. Okay, let's look at technology. Look at oil. Okay, oil has a rebound over here. We still have this top channel. Okay, these are 80. 80 is the point lah, that it breaks through. So we have to watch 80. That's why I said until it break above 80, right? I'm not very keen that I don't think it got another big push up. It need to go through 80, right? Because we have a downtrend channel here. Okay, so the price already start to follow the downtrend here and broke below the downtrend channel, means it's very strong downtrend. But now it's starting to rebound, right? It's starting to rebound. RSI go through 50, but we have to see that it still has this big dark cloud. Okay, at 80, it need to go through before it can really go. So this one is still, we have to look. I'm not saying that it got no chance because it's making higher high. It is rebounding, but it haven't breakthrough yet. The problem is it breakthrough, right? This is a breakthrough, right? It's a downtrend, okay? Okay, a breakthrough. What happened after breakthrough? A big push, right? So this one is still no breakthrough, right? The breakthrough should be here. So there's no breakthrough yet. So we have to still wait. Look at this semiconductor. Look at NASDAQ. Okay, NASDAQ is holding at the all-time high. So it cannot break through all-time high. Look like got some pressure over here. RSI got divergence. Look like it's coming down temporarily. Looks like NASDAQ. Semiconductor index went back up, now coming back down. Okay, this could be a false break. If this one is a false break, then this one could continue come down. RSI coming down, so not so good this one for now. Look like this is just maybe it's also window dressing. So be careful, this one might start to drop. But the most important place is here. It cannot drop below here. 3739. Once it drop below 3739, means this one downtrend will continue. Now it's still sideways. Okay. This is not so good lah. This now we see this, right? It's a broadening top. We call this a broadening top. This pattern, right? Broadening top, right? Normally what happened after a broadening top, right? It's a downtrend. It's a reversal of the trend. Be careful first, but I'm not saying that this will happen, but we have to watch out. We have to watch out already. Hopefully this one can rebound here. What we want is next week. Okay, it can rebound. Once it rebound clear this area, means it's very strong. Okay, means it want to go up. But if it cannot rebound, continue to drop like that, right? Then it's then we will have a possible drop. CPI. Now we can see CPO already. Palm oil. Okay, so palm oil. Remember we said here, right? Palm oil. We said here. Okay, here we've got 44.868. We have a strong support over here, the middle channel, right? So now it's the rebound from the middle channel. It also broke out from this trend line. Really looks like oil is coming back. Palm oil is coming back. I think palm oil possibly got one more push up. So you guys already got stuck with palm oil, maybe got chance to escape. So next week maybe want to monitor the palm oil a little bit. RSI also go through 50 already. I think palm oil maybe got one more push up. Okay, so you guys remember, now you want to open CGS CIMB account, just click forms here. Okay, you just fill in your information, your name, gender, age, phone number, mobile phone number, email, and your broadcast, whether you want to get English or Chinese broadcast. Okay, and all the link is here. All the link is here. See more here. Open Luno account for trading. Cryptocurrency now year end. Okay, all the fund managers selling their crypto to take profit. So now it's not the time to jump in. YouTube channel, my coffee page. This one buy who move my cheese, apply for time fiber, open trading view account and chat pattern analysis book. So all the link is here at the top of my Facebook. So you don't need to find. And also, okay, want to buy me coffee, remember, okay, coffee.com, q-fi.com, trading VKS, okay, just click the how many cup you want to buy, okay, just click tip, okay, and then you can continue, okay, so this one, right, don't forget, I got four chapter here, okay, I got four chapter here, how to use technical chart, how to use chart to trick KLSE, this one based on KLSE screener, somewhat look the same, like with a trading view. If you already know how to use KLSE screener,
It's quite the same lah. It's quite the same with this trading view, huh? So you can actually learn. I got four chapter over here, four chapter English, four chapter Chinese lah. So when I say RSI lah, resistance lah, support lah, trend line lah, I already elaborate in the video. So after you watch the video, you understand what I talk about channel lah, support lah, what RSI. RSI oversold lah, RSI overbought lah, all these things you will understand lah. Okay, so look at our sector ah. Okay, first we want to look at is of course consumer, right? Consumer, as I said, consumer is following this KLCI. KLCI continue to go up, consumer continue to go up. This one, remember we talk about consumer, why consumer got chance to go, right? Because here, right, remember, severely oversold. Remember when COVID, the first time the COVID MCO came, right? That's the time that this RSI severely way below oversold here. This is the first COVID, right? First COVID MCO. When market big scare, big drop, then V-shaped recovery, right? Big V-shaped recovery, okay? So this is another time that RSI went drop below oversold quite far. You see, it never dropped below oversold very far before. This is another time after the big scare, Omicron scare, big COVID scare, Omicron scare, now it dropped very low. Okay, so is this another V-shaped recovery, right? We want to know, right? Okay, is it another V-shaped recovery? So this is probable, okay, means high percentage that it would happen. Because history tell us, right? We can see history. We don't invest with our eyes closed, right? We open our eyes, we see the history. History tell us when severely oversold, the price it start to rebound, right? Normally it can go, okay, it has a V-shaped recovery. How far we don't know, but already started the V-shaped recovery, right? You can see, right? Already started the V-shaped recovery, right? We talked about this one, right? V-shaped recovery this is a V-shaped recovery, right? So it restarted. How far can it go? We don't know. It might stop here or it might continue, but so far it's still okay. But now it got a very strong resistance to break, okay, which is here, this one, 577, okay, a very big resistance to break. If it can go through 577, right, means it can, okay, it will continue go probably to the top channel here, 592. So now we got a strong resistance over here. Maybe it might correct and it might try again. Or maybe it will direct go. We don't know yet. But so far, okay, so far, V-shaped recovery has started. V-shaped recovery has started. So next week, you have to see consumer. Is it keep on green? Then we know that it's broken through 577. It should continue go up. If to next week, we see all red, means if you correct one more time, possible, it will try again before it go up. Or before it go down. Okay. Healthcare. Oh, healthcare broken through 2285. So healthcare got some momentum finally. Healthcare got some momentum. This is very important. 2285 is very important. Okay, it's the first barrier that you need to go through. This one, look at Friday, right? Friday, right, could be window dressing, right? Because we see what happened Friday. Top Glove went up, Supermax didn't go up, Hatta go up, Kosan go up, but all the other smaller one, HLT, Roborex, all those never go up. That means it's a final window dressing. So this one could be window dressing. Next week, if it fall back down, means a force break, means it will continue go down. Okay, if next week it can hold above here, maybe got something to play. I think maybe got something to play. Pick a bit bottom, maybe can little bit bottom. My confidence line is 24. Okay, 2402. You need to go through 2402. Then got better chance. But this one, best, the most I will do is buy little bit test water only. Because why? Okay. The fundamental is not good lah. Omicron under control already. What will cause the glove price to go up, right? this pandemic, right? Now pandemic, Omicron can be controlled by the vaccine already, first thing. Then secondly, South Africa saying that Omicron also slowing down already, right? So this is not, that doesn't have that much of a chance, right, for this one. But there is some news that saying that the ASP, glove ASP might be coming back up. So this one we have to monitor. So this one maybe got a chance for this healthcare, this glove. And vaccine-wise, okay, vaccine doing well. Fundamental-wise, P&L-wise, all the glove company, we don't expect it to make the big profit like last time. Now came back to maybe before pandemic, the profit they make, right? Possibly somewhere over there, like previous, before pandemic, possible like that. So we don't expect, I cannot expect, like last time, Top Glove go back to 9 ringgit. I can't see that. Maybe it can happen, but I can't see that. So maybe it still can go, maybe it still can go a bit higher here, but Goring Kau Kau, I don't think so, but you see, right, every push up, as I said, right, 5 times push up, right, 7 times push up, 5 times you lose money, 2 times you make money, right? So that is the odds, I really tell the odds, right? Okay, the odds, right, last time, right? So this year, right, since we start from this year, 2021, we talk about here. 1 time you make money, this one you should be losing, this time you should be losing. You buy this time, right, the rebound, right, you lose, maybe this time you make. So only these 2 times you make. Other time you buy the rebound, you lost. Okay, you lose. So most of the time you buy any rebound, right, you lose. So 5 times lose, 2 times win. So this is how, this is just, I don't see how to justify to throw a lot of money into this glove. For me, it's not that I'm saying that it cannot, but I don't see it. Plantation looks like coming back. So Plantation looks like coming back. 6683, we want to see. Okay. Once it go through 6683, right, means it's coming, this one is going back inside the channel. Okay, means that it have a good chance to continue to grow. So far we are still having a real resistance at 6683, so we have to see here whether it can go through or not. So far there's some rebound, but there is a very strong resistance at 6683. So I'm not saying that this one can looks very good, but so far short-term rebound for you to run, yes. Long-term to invest in, I don't see it yet. Transportation, logistic trying to rebound also. Logistic look quite strong, higher high, looks quite strong. $873, probably want to look at here, $873. Okay, once you go through 873, I think probably it got chance to continue to go. Now possible it's a short term rebound because it need to clear this one. Need to clear 873, which is this trend line. If you cannot clear this trend line, it will come back down again. So this one, short term rebound, yes. Short term run, yes. Long term investment, maybe we want to see next week. Finance, okay. Finance very strong, right? We talk about here going up very strong. Now it reached the resistance already, right? Our channel top, you see, right? Hit the channel top, come back down, right? That's why the technical analysis is very important, right? You can see, okay, you can see where's the opportunity, where's the danger, right? Where's the opportunity? Okay, it breaks above here, then it's an opportunity, right? If it cannot break above here, come back down, this is the danger, right? Okay, so the sentiment is it's okay, okay, but the history tells us what? History telling us this line is the most important line. Okay, it cannot go through means it will come back. It can go through means very likely it will continue to go up. So this one, watch a few more days for finance. So far, already have a short-term rebound, as expected last week. We said that this one, right? Head and shoulder, right? Okay, so it's supposed to come back to here, right? Because this is a length, right? This is the length. The head and the neck and the head, right? So it reached the target here, right? Okay, So this one, watch a few more days, see what happened. RSI already go through 50 coming back. It should have this correction a bit. Now it's correcting. Okay, having a correction. So once it's... once after correction, see whether it can go through or not. So now, basically, right, now all these are reacting according to KLCI, right? KLCI big push, right? Now KLCI also by itself also, it will reach some kind of pressure over here, right? Pressure over here, overextended, right? Okay, and RSI also overbought. So there's some pressure over to correct. Most likely this one will follow also. Okay, all these will follow to correct a bit before it try to break up again. See KLCI, after KLCI correct, right? After KLCI correct, whether it rebound or after it correct, it continue drop. If it correct, it continue drop, means this one, most likely all this will follow. All this will follow after this correction, it will follow drop. Okay, if KLCI after the big correction, okay, after correction, it still rebound up, means this one will follow, continue up. So now all this, we have to wait, KLCI wait what happened. But so far this one, financial got some rebound, it's quite strong. Energy, we are still waiting for 701 area, so we haven't go through. So most of them now, right, is in the junction. Left and right. Left, it continue go up. Left, it drop. Right, it continue go up, right? So it's at the junction now. Most of them is the junction. We have to watch next week. What KLCI does, okay? KLCI continue to be strong. All this will continue. You see, all this at the junction, right? All this at the support resistance, big. Major support resistance, all these, right? Consumer, all this energy, all these, right? Finance, all these at this important support resistance area. Okay, so KLCI continue to break, continue up. This one all will break. Okay, this one will break. This one will break. You see, right? Finance is where? Finance is having this. So all this in the junction. Okay. So we want to see KLCI, see which way KLCI goes. This one will, all this will follow. All this in the junction. So now all this are 50-50 or something like 50-50. So all these are something like 50-50. Similar to energy. Okay, energy, we have a resistance over here. So this one is still, we have to wait and see 50-50. See whether it can go through telecom. Got some rebound telecom launching of 5G coming this one finally so got some rebound. This one you want to buy one, two stock maybe, okay, RSI go through 50, so there are some sign of rebound but you got very strong resistance over here. So this is a downtrend trend. If you can break above, then this is very good. Okay, this downtrend channel. If you cannot break above, means it's still considered a downtrend. Possible a temporary rebound. Technology, so everyone wants to know about technology, right? Okay, so technology continue to be sideways, quite strong last few days. Okay, the price already trying to break above this area, 97, which I said is very important, right? Now it's sideways, right? Okay, go through 97 means uptrend coming, maybe coming back. Drop below 94 means downtrend already. So you have to be careful this one. So down, you see all these is in the junction, right? All this stock is in the junction, waiting for the big picture, waiting for KLCI to what happened to KLCI, right? Property. See property also, right? You see property also in this junction, right? Okay, the previous resist support over here now become resistant, right? So all in this junction, all is waiting for KLCI next week. So this one also now hitting resistant, we have to wait and see. All is 50-50 construction. Okay, you see construction also here, right? This one. Okay, the big resistance, right? The big resistance over here. So you see it also reaching here, it's trying to break. So next week, okay, now all the stock is still, okay, we are looking at a 50-50, waiting for the big picture to come, waiting for KLCI. Except industry, okay? Industry broken through already. Industry is really strong, broken through already. Looks like it want to continue up. So industry is one that is what I would say is bullish. Others are 50-50 waiting for KLCI. Industry is strong. Industry quite strong. broken through already there. The resistance is here. The major resistance is here. Okay, so now it's broken through already. This one looks good. Industry. Okay, look at small cap. Now we added something new, right? Now we got more and more information. Look at small cap. I know you guys like to play a lot of small cap. Big cap, a bit difficult to play. Small cap, let's look at small cap chart. Let me see. Give me a while. I put in the support resistance. Small cap doesn't look very strong. Small cap has been climbing long, have been going very strong until April. After April, just basically they are sideways only. Sideways only. Drop, went up, drop. So this is not very strong. Small cap. Now I think now basically it's on a downtrend already. Until it can break above here, then we can change it, become an uptrend. Now the small cap is really downtrend. Once it go to 16,466, then only we can consider this as an uptrend. Now maybe there's a short term correction up to this area. Now maybe there's a short term correction. Maybe there's a bottom over here, already reached a bottom over here. Now maybe there's a small correction. Also there is some to play for this small cap, but short term doesn't look at a very long term. Long term already passed already here. These are long term. Now this one only short term play only, small cap. Okay, I think that's it for today. Don't forget, tomorrow we're going to recap all the stock we talk about this whole week. Okay, and Happy New Year, Happy Holiday. Bye bye.